Governor Brewer's plans to deal with a huge budget shortfall include substantial cuts to higher education. In a moment, we'll hear from the president of Arizona State University and the chair of the Arizona Board of Regents. But first, here's what the governor's budget director had to say about proposed cuts earlier this week on Horizon.
There's no question that budget reductions are placing a strain on the university system, as they have on all of state government. Certainly, higher education is a big portion of the state budget. We spend about $900 million on the university system. So what we are proposing is a reduction of that support of $170 million. It's about 20% of their total state support. You look at the total funds of the state university system, and there's state support, there's tuition dollars that flow into the system, and the enterprise funds that come into the system, and then also federal dollars. And federal dollars are largely dedicated to specific projects, but it's money that comes into the university system. So the question has been, if you reduce state support, does that necessarily mean that tuition goes up? And we don't believe so. What the governor has called on the state university system to do, and she called for this 2 years ago, recognizing that this cliff, this budget cliff, was coming. She said, we need you to look into your processes, what you're doing, what your education and finance models are, and find new ways to educate Arizonans at a high standard at a lower cost.
Here now to talk about the proposed cuts to higher education is Ann Mariucci, chair of the Arizona Board of Regents, and Dr. Michael Crow, president of Arizona State University. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us. Higher, we're talking $170 million reduced for FY12. Impact on Arizona State University, on all universities here in the state.
Well, I'll comment on behalf of the system, all three universities together. The number is not a tremendous surprise to us. It's a serious number, but more importantly, I think we focus on what's happened on a cumulative basis since the cutting started in fiscal 08. And on that basis, we've been cut $400 million, while our system has grown in enrollment by just about 20% of the students. So we measure everything on a per FTE, full-time equivalent student basis. And on that basis, our state appropriation has been cut by 46%, or just under $5,000 a student. And that's serious business.
Serious business?
Absolutely serious. I mean, on the per student basis, the way to look at this, I mean, we're working our way through, and we're all trying to carry a part of our part of the challenge, if you will, of living through this economic shift in the Arizona economy and the American economy. It's serious business, because for us, the first round of the cuts in 08 was a 30-year reduction on a per student basis. The proposed recommendations coming from the governor, which I know was a very difficult decision for her because she is committed to education, represent for us a 50-year reduction on a per-student basis. So these are serious challenges for which we've got to do all kinds of things to respond to them.
What kinds of things? Are we talking enrollment caps? Are you looking at larger class sizes, fewer class options, furloughs? I mean, is everything now being considered with a cut of this size?
I think the most important thing we're looking at is how can we innovate? How can we drive the university into new ways of doing things that can improve our quality of our outcomes, enhance our efficiency and our effectiveness, and lower our cost on a per student basis? So the first thing we're going to do is continue to advance innovations. And then in addition to that, we will have to reduce our costs in certain programs. We will have to shift programs, link programs, and combine programs. We'll have to do all of that.
We heard the governor's budget director saying that the universities have to find new ways to educate Arizonans at a higher standard but at a lower cost. First of all, is that doable? And secondly, is that process underway?
It's absolutely doable. It is our mandate. It's something that we've been working on for, you know, many years now. The pace will accelerate because, you know, this level of crisis has proven to be a real accelerator. Now, some of those things can be done with minimal amount of capital investment. Others that have been suggested and called for, such as a state college system, obviously is an enormous brick and mortar undertaking, and the capital to finance that is of unknown means at this time. But online education, more efficient academic delivery on campus, off campus, regional campuses, more partnerships with community colleges, all of that is not new to us. We're well down the road of implementing that. This just provides an accelerator.
Is that how you see it as well? And you talked about an opportunity for innovation. I'm hearing accelerator as well. It's still $170 million out of that next fiscal year budget. That's a lot of money.
This is a massive reduction, and the state, in its wisdom, will have to decide at what point not going to be able to really advance the universities as the powerful drivers of social and economic success that they have been for the last few decades. They have a duty to do that, and they're in my opinion, very close to that point where their duty needs to be carefully thought about. But having said that, it also is our responsibility to determine how to scale the model. So as public higher education continues to be of higher demand, we have to find ways to provide it at a cost that's not ever increasing. And so that means through some combination of tuition investment, private investment, and public investment, we have to find a way to operate the university without its costs continuing to rise.
Can you do that without increasing tuition? I mean, we're close. Aren't we reasonably close now to the national average? I mean, how much more can tuition be raised?
For us, it's not so much the price of tuition, but the cost to the individual student. And so what we are operating under is what we call a modest tuition, high financial aid model. That model for ASU and for our sister institutions has been more successful than the low tuition, low financial aid model. That was a less successful model. This is a more successful model. We now have to take that model to the next level. Can we advance without tuition adjustments? The answer is we can't adjust that quickly, even if we were innovating at the fastest possible rate. And so it's probably going to be some combination of cuts and tuition adjustments that we'll be proposing to the Regents.
I ask the question because I know a lot of folks watching right now are very concerned about tuition rates and see them going up and say, wait a minute, I thought it was supposed to be as close to as free as possible and other constitutional mandates. What's going on here? What is going on? What can you tell them?
Well, what I can tell them is that we are very, very sensitive to it. It's become more sensitive as we have hit that midpoint compared to national averages. At the same time, I think the public needs to understand some nuances underneath those numbers. And just let me give you an example. We've increased the sticker price of tuition by order magnitude 50% in the last 3 years. However, almost 50 cents of every incremental dollar has gone to financial aid. As a result, I think the Arizona public would be very surprised to know that the average tuition actually paid by an in-state undergrad student is $2,200 a year. 45% of the undergrad students are paying zero. Okay? So just like anything you shop for today, you know, rarely do you really pay sticker. Never before has that relationship been more pronounced at the universities. And I would say that at $2,200 a year, that's about the greatest bargain for a higher education with the quality that we put out in the state that anybody could ask for. At the same time, we're very, very sensitive to it.
We had the legislative leaders on last week. We talked about university cuts, and they both mentioned that they considered universities among those protected from cuts compared to the rest of the state government, and that there's no pot of money anywhere for anything, much less something like universities. I mean, that's basically what they said. How do you respond to that?
Well, I think that the error in the calculation might be, if you look at our total budget, all of our revenue sources, and you take some of our funding away from the state, you'd say, well, it's a small percentage of cut. Unfortunately, our instructional programs have two sources of revenue, tuition and state investment. And within those areas of the university's operation, we can't move in money from federal grants and from gifts for program X or from other kinds of programs that we have. It doesn't work that way. And so there might be a miscalculation in the cut. The cuts are on a per student basis. At least at ASU, we're at 50% with these additional recommendations being made on a per student basis. At the same time, if you look at the overall budget of the university, it would appear to be small, but you can't look at it that way.
Well, we did have one lawmaker look at the overall budget of the universities, and he said he found that the universities have more money today than they did in 2008. First of all, is that accurate? And secondly, how do you respond to it?
Mm-hmm. In a way, it is accurate. And it goes largely to what Michael just said. There's resources that come into the universities that are for very specific, dedicated purposes. We can't use them for instruction. Okay, if you're counting those, I mean, the research functions at the universities have had banner years, and I'm very proud of that. That brings distinction to this state. On the other hand, the amount that we have to spend on a per-student basis to educate our young people has irrefutably decreased by 40% to 50%.
Let me just add to that. So speaking now only for ASU, because I know the numbers better, our total amount of resources that we have on a per-student basis, even with tuition going up, is actually less than it was when we started this process. So our total amount of money has gone down on a per-student basis that we have available to us.
Right. Now, to be fair to that point of view, we were uniquely benefited by the federal stimulus to the tune of $220-odd million. But that was a one-time windfall, per se, that gave us a reprieve, gave us breathing room for a year to prepare for the cliff, as Governor Brewer aptly refers it to. Mm-hmm. It is not a long-term, sustainable, permanent then addition to our funding. It was a one-time deal. So I credit the universities and the presidents for not spending that money the minute it came in the door. So have they created a bit of a rainy day fund to allow for some of this cliff coming? Yes, and I think that's been good management and good leadership.
Last question. I'm a lawmaker. Talk to me. Convince me that $170 million cut in FY12, when everything is getting cut, that this is going to seriously impact the universities and is something that lawmakers should reconsider.
Well, I think all lawmakers have to look at issues that are actually higher level than this. That is, this problem, this $170 million cut, is a symptom of a structural problem in Arizona financing. There are deep structural issues. We have the largest structural deficit of all 50 states. That structural deficit, even with these cuts, isn't going to go away. So my hope is, and one of the things that I've been urging legislators to do, is to sort of go up to the 50,000-foot level from the 20,000-foot level where they're trying to adjust this or adjust that, and really look at that structural deficit. It's not a deficit that's driven by the economy going up or down. It's a deficit that's inherent in the structure of a not well-aligned overall financial model for the state.
All right, we got to stop it right there. Good to see you. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.